2019 League of Legends All-Star Weekend live from Shanghai, China. I'm Joe Miller, and next to me is Joshua Jack Leisman. And it's finally time for to get underway with Game 1, the European LCS All-Stars taking on the Korean OGN champions. But before we get into the game, we're having a bit of an update for the reason for that little delay, Jack.
Yeah, in the first game of China versus USA, there was a Zed bug that happened where he was picking up some assists where he shouldn't have been able to. So Zed is now banned from the tournament while we investigate and verify that the source of the bug. We're going to move on with the games, but no Zed.
No Zed for this first game, at least, as we fix all that stuff going on. So we're finally getting close to champion select for game one between the European LCS All-Stars and the Korean OGN champions. So we've already talked a little bit about those bans and picks, but since we're actually really getting into them now, let's try and narrow that one down a little bit. So what can we expect? You mentioned before, targeted bans is probably the way that this thing's going to go down.
And really, it's about who do you decide to target. Maybe they'll go for Alex Each, specifically because the Kha'Zix was kind of brought out by him. He does love to stick with the AD casters. No Kha'Zix, no Zed as well. So it'll be very interesting to see how this works out.
Yeah, and to talk about Alex Each and, you know, what bans could possibly go his way in the regular season, 100% with Kha'Zix win in the spring split, not including the playoffs, I must add to that. 100% with Kassadin in the spring split when he played him. And then also had 100% with Zed, who unfortunately won't be even available for him this choice around. But there's already two big standouts there if the Koreans have done their research.
And just to make sure that we have no miscommunications here, that the Zed thing, is if we verify and find out, then they're going to decide how to act with it. It's not a whole said and done thing. But yeah, absolutely, Alex. You know, you get pretty impressive numbers when you win almost every game as well. How many casting games did he play?
Yeah, it was a slightly less amount than, you know, maybe your normal sample size would be, but it's 100% nonetheless.
It's still really potent.
And it's more than two games, which is a great thing anyway. I mean, we know how strong Kassadin is. We've seen how many, specifically in Europe, I mean, the mid laners in Europe have gone to war with Kassadin for the picks and the bans on him.
Specifically, more than other regions.
Yeah.
You don't really see Kassadin outside of that. And when it was there, he was either fourth or fifth picked almost every single time you'd see him. So if they're going to be going for something like that, it's very cautiously doing so. When you're against a matchup that can't just murder you, you see it against Karthus sometimes. And I know Ambition's actually been playing a fair bit of Karthus as well recently, or at least over in the OGN it's been pretty big. So that could definitely be something that sneaks in late, but can't be sure.
Yeah, there's a whole host of bans that come out from this one. We talked about the top lane and how Shy and Soaz, both players who have, you know, constantly brought out different champions left, right, and center. Even innovative, I mean, you look at Soaz, and he was really the first one to have that Kha'Zix in the top lane. The Jace was his big one as well, when we think back to actually what were the qualifiers for LCS, which is why Soaz, ironically, is even here at this point. Even though they lost that tournament, it was the game that they had against Curse EU where he first brought out the Jace in the top lane, and pretty much stomped with it there. So, you know, and that's where people really realize, okay, this Soaz guy, he's a bit unpredictable. And then we saw, of course, a Blitzcrank top lane from him as well.
And I know it's going to be going way back as far as Soaz goes, but we talked how Alex was like bringing out the Kha'Zix mid. At IPO 5 in December, when we're still in Season 2 patch for the game, he played Kha'Zix top lane. He was the first one to break it out in competitive. I can only hope he has something similar for us today in top lane, but he's already done so much. And there's only 112 champions, as big as that sounds.
Only 112, but I'd like to see something new. But you have to wonder if this is really the stage for it as well. You know,
Probably not. It is
an all-star game, and you know, as such, you'd think, well, they're more like exhibition games. You might want to risk things here and there. But the fact is that one region is going to have an extra spot for the World Championship. Now, that is a huge deal for, it could be at least, for any single one of these players.
And not only can they get the first round bye. So sorry, not only can they also get the first round bye.
Spoiler.
I jumped to the conclusion right there. If they don't finish last place in this tournament, so one win and your region's top seeded team just doesn't have to play in the World Finals group stage part.
Which look at Europe, you've got, you know, three men from Gambit, second overall in the spring split in the playoffs there, and of course Soaz from Fnatic, who's like, well, we could do that number one again, and that would put us in a very, very nice position come the World Championships. Then you've got EG, who you never know, they might be fighting through, but we are finally into champion select.
Yeah.
Let's have a look down the bans.
Diana first ban away from Ambition. That is definitely a smart ban coming up. I somehow slipped my mind because we have five All-Stars that all have pretty much ban-worthy champion pools, but that's exactly what EU decided to go with.
Yeah, second ban coming out here. Well, the first ban for OGN was Nasus. Actually, the second most played champion by Diamond in the Spring Split. He's most played champion in the Spring Split, and his second most champion played in the playoffs. So a big pick Nasus, and they decided to take that out.
And I think one of the other champions that Diamond was huge on was Volibear as well. And
correct.
Since Volibear's seen a few nerfs, I can definitely see why they'd have the Nasus ban before that. Zac could be either a jungle ban for Diamond or something else, but from those first two bans, it actually looks like Korea's targeting out Diamond as someone they want to shut down.
And on the other side, we can see that Diana and Kha'Zix both banned out here by the European LCS All-Stars. And Ambition's like, oh, come on, guys, I want to have a go at this one. And Thresh is going to be taken out. We touched on this one earlier. Both Madlife and Edward are fantastic Thresh players in Europe, saying, you know what, we've got the Thresh Prince, but let's not lose our crown in this one.
It's a little unfortunate, but like we saw in the other one, since they banned out the Thresh, we get the first pick, Rumble. That was amazing for PDD in the game against North America. He was just 1v2ing pretty much the entire game.
Yeah, at the start we saw that 1v2, which left us, you know, open mouthed. It's like, what did he just do with that one? And Rumble, again, another one that SOAS more than familiar with. Over on the other side, we were talking about Jace already. We were talking about him for SOAS, though. Looks like the OGN All-Stars could go for that one. And also, there is the Lee Sin as well for Insect, maybe.
And we have no idea where this Jace would be going, because Shy's Jace has been impeccable in the past few games. He's actually been drawing bans from it. But we see Jace mid lane very frequently, too. So that pick of Jace is giving them a lot of versatility. Of course, the pick for Lee Sin, though, gets everyone a little bit excited. We don't see much Lee Sin jungle anymore over in the LCS, but especially in the OGN Champions, he's everywhere, and Insect is great.
Yeah, we're going to move looking like towards the AD carries, which I think is a good progression for the European LCS All-Stars at this point, because obviously no one from the OGN Champions picked that AD carry up. Looks like we will be seeing Avaris, the most hotly contended AD carry right now, and they're hanging around Kennen as well.
And I got to say, throughout most of the world, Varus is the guy that everyone's been picking. I think some of it has to do with the fact that he's the one guy who brings the AoE crowd control on us all, aside from Ashe, so. The one guy. There we go. That was a true statement. But it's another thing is because of the prevalence of the AD casters mid, like Kha'Zix or Zed, Varus is adding that extra bit of crowd control and letting you lose it in other places, because sure, Rumble has the equalizer, but to keep people in it, the Varus can help that from an AD carry position, which is something almost no other AD carry can offer.
So Kennen has been locked in here as well, looking like it'll most probably end up in the hands of Alexic there, that Kennen. Now, Korea and Kennen have become one recently.
True.
It's been a very, very hotly contested pick over in Korea, which almost makes me think, it surprised me it wasn't picked up in that first round, but at the same time, also unsurprising then that the Europeans wanted to take that away.
I really think it was a counter pick in the truest sense of the word. OGN didn't expect them to take Kennen, as far as if I had to guess, and they were willing to lock up the Jace and Lee Sin before the Kennen was available. Because let's not forget, Diamond became famous a lot of times on his Lee Sin way back in the day, so they could have wanted to kind of steal that away from him, and in response, that's why we saw the Kennen from.
And now we see the AD carry coming out, and look at this. Edward is hovering over Blitzcrank. We know Edward as a master troll when it comes to champion select, so we'll not talk about that one just too much yet. But on the other side, Ryze, a champion which Alexic was famed for, and he's come out openly and said, that is my favorite pick. And it's going to be Ambition running that this time around, and it will be Evelynn and Blitzcrank locked in. Now, Evelynn, flashback to the playoffs, we saw Diamond with Evelynn in the jungle.
That's probably where he's going, too. That's a jungle Eve. He actually does Lizard, Elder, the AD Spirit Stone on Evelynn for really fast clears, and then goes into his AP item. So we have to be able to keep track of that. And just to go over to the OGN lineup here, right now Ambition and Shy are in that order. I wouldn't be too surprised if we saw a swap, because CDant is Blaze, the sister team to Frost, has played Ryze top twice in their best of three game back in the quarterfinals. And we do know that the Jace does go mid, but I guess because Shy is such a big Jace player, he's going to stick it solid. But it does give the mind game thought to Europe where he's actually going to be going.
So Madlife here, Alistar. Madlife was Mr. Alistar back in the day. You know, before we started seeing these ridiculous clips coming out from Blitzcrank and the Thresh, his Alistar is top, top, top notch here. So really excited to see that one.
I like how he's going back to the Alistar for the All-Star game, because he's only played it super sparingly in the last little bit of Champions. But that is just his one true champion, it kind of feels like. I remember a specific highlight video back when he was playing, actually, CLG EU, so Yellow Pete's going to remember this, where he was just destroying Froggen's Diana in almost every fight, just keeping him out of it by himself. And for this game, he's probably going to be looking to headbutt the cannon out of teamfights before he can get off his Zhonya's and keep his ultimate out of the game.
Yeah, that's going to be a vital part of things here, definitely for the OGN Champions All-Stars. Fair to pick this one up then. So, what are we thinking? I mean, Edward picking up that Blitzcrank against MadLife is a bold statement, and we know Edward is a man who likes to make bold statements in that regard. Really interested to see how this one works out.
And the one thing we didn't really catch there is Blitzcrank pulling in an Alistar is usually a really bad idea.
Yeah.
So of all the counterpicks that we actually kind of saw here, we haven't really seen many counterpicks, it seems, in the last season. People have kind of defaulted back to just picking their compositions and for themselves. There's a lot of counterpicking going down in this All-Star game.
And I think the official word, Jack, for picking up that Alistar at the end there when there's a Blitzcrank is a cow to pick. Because, of course, he is a cow. Get that one out of the way before we get into the game, I think.
Well done.
So 62% of you, at least earlier on when we were looking over at lolesports.com, of course, were voting for the European All-Stars to pick up the victory here for this one. Don't forget, you can still do that and throughout this best of three. So going to be a very interesting one. What are we expecting here in terms of early game? I mean, have we got some obvious lane switches in there right now?
Well, I think the biggest thing before even the lanes are decided is the power that both of these teams possess at level one.
At level one.
When you see a Blitzcrank on one side, plus an Alistar on the other, and things to combo up with it on top of that. So as people don't realize, the E on Rumble is 1,000 range, or 950, one of those two numbers. So if they pull someone in, once they flash away, they're still gonna get caught by the slow, and they will be dead. Likewise, if you pulverize someone, Shy can follow it up with a Rune Prison, so both of these teams, if they look to make aggressive moves early, we could see kills at a much higher percentage than we would normally see.
Danger, danger here at level one between the EU LCS All-Stars and the OGN Champions. Let's see how things kick off. Great to see Lee Sin in action here as well. And you know, Diamond was a player that always Lee Sin,
yeah,
ban after ban, and then really stopped playing him. He actually just fell out of favor with a lot of the junglers that were playing him before.
I think it was a combination of him just losing interest in him and also opting for junglers with high amounts of reliability. If you just think of the way Volibear and Nasus work, you don't make mechanical mistakes on them. It's all about your judgment. But Lee Sin is a combination of the two. And it's a risky champion that has high rewards. And that just hasn't been the type of junglers Diamond's been going with recently.
Well, let's have a look here at level one. Lots of wards down already here, specifically from the red team. Of course, the OGN champions, see, they have four of them set up right now across the map. Couple already down for the European All-Stars. And there is a pink ward in there as well. Interesting enough for Alex H and for Edward here at the start. Jack, does that indicate something special here from Europe?
I don't think it's necessarily something special. It just means they are really worried about Lee Sin and they want to make sure they have ward control. If you can get past the early game with Lee Sin, you're kind of home free. And Eve's early ganks aren't necessarily that powerful. Plus, if they're looking for Eve's ganks to work, they want these pink wards, that's it. They want these pink wards to clear out the enemy's regular wards so that Diamond's ganks are much more threatening.
Yeah, it's gonna be an important part of it, having that control. We've just seen there, Diamond Brooks picking up that blue buff on his side of things. His bottom lane, of course, gonna be an interesting one to watch. The self-confessed passive AD carry player of Yellow Pete with a self-confessed maniac on Blitzcrank that is, of course, Edward. MadLife and Prey on the other team, both highly accomplished players that have got such a great following, and I think MadLife in particular, as you said, god in Korea.
And even though MadLife spent so much time with Woom, who was a very defensive AD carry early on, his AD carry he's playing with now, Hermes, is very similar in style to what Prey has. So even though they're not the same combo right now, OGN's bottom lane should have a high amount of aggressive synergy.
And we did, of course, see I guess we can say a bit of switching going on there. I mean, Ryze did end up going to the top with Jace in the middle. The players who, you know, we've touted as the middle and top laner are playing both then. So Shy on that Ryze with the Jace on Ambition in middle lane.
It really seems fitting that these guys are deciding to actually just lane against each other. For the first time in a real long time, we saw a little bit of it in North America versus China. But for now, it's almost a dare by OGN saying, we're going to fight you even though you guys have the double golem advantage in bottom lane, because we just like the Alistar versus Blitzcrank matchup that much.
So let's have a look here in middle, because Diamond has managed to sneak his way through. Sneaky being, of course, invisible at this stage in towards that middle lane here. Ambition is going to be watching, and he's fairly decently placed here for him to get in. We are going to see him coming down. Alex is trying to get in there. The flash going to be used, but the stun comes down. Ambition is in a lot of trouble. Can he get finished off here? Yes, he can. First blood Alex with the auto attack at the finisher.
Gank by the European LCS squad there. That's a lot of synergy that they've built through years together on Gambit Gaming. They juggled the turret aggro just right. Even though they burned the flash, they got the stun post-flash, and they really just dove in together, making sure neither of them got crushed by the turret, securing that first blood as well as burning the flash.
Yeah, it makes massive sense here, of course, for Diamond to be involved in this middle lane as Insect is actually going in here on towards Alex Inch, but he'll simply run his way away from that one. Going fairly low from it though, but Insect, you know, just trying to mark a bit of territory around this middle lane, say Diamond's not having it for free.
And if there's any time Insect's gonna want to pick up farm, it's in the free lanes. He's never gonna miss that opportunity. You can actually see he's keeping pace right now with all the other people in the game as far as minion kills go, picking up that free stuff. And I gotta say, the escape that Alex made to that Lee Sin gank was actually pretty good. He waited until after Insect had detonated his Q to get him to come towards him before he eat away, making sure there's really no risk.
No risk involved. Of course, that first blood for Alex Itch as he goes back home will bring out the boots and a ruby crystal. Compare that over to Jesu. Doran's blade, kind of very charming there as well. But look at this, Evelyn is once again waiting.
And they know, since there's no flash, if he gets behind him in the slightest, Ambition is gonna die. The red buff's still up.
Red buff is still up, and Diamond is just hanging around there. And he went through the acceleration gate. I think Diamond just waiting for that speed boost to just stop there and then get himself back off into that lane. In the end, not worth any risk at this point. Europe are ahead by a 400 gold margin after 5.5 minutes, and now that stealthy Evelyn is coming down bottom.
And I may have been completely wrong when I said that Evelyn's early game wasn't the greatest ganking tool. I haven't seen enough jungle leap, and especially not enough of Diamond's jungle leap, because he has been absolutely everywhere. And I think that Europe LCS scared off OGN a little bit with all those pink wards early, completely just blacking out the vision, knowing that the regular wards will not save you from the ganks right now, and the map pressure is kind of visibly showing in the way the OGN lanes are playing.
So Diamond, in the playoffs where we saw him pull out that Evelyn, had the top KDA in the jungle. He had 22 kills. The next closest jungler to him in that one was Cyanide of Fnatic with just 6 kills. So you just saw exactly the power of Diamond there from those statistics coming out. Right now, bottom lane being fairly passive for what we're used to with these two setups.
And I think it's just the fear of pulling in an Alistar. Sometimes you just pull in the initiation. So one of the best ways to mute this lane by Edward is to not go, but Insect lands it.
They're gonna run in towards Edward. He's in a lot of trouble as he tries to flash away. He got knocked up at the same time. It's only one more auto attack. Insect gonna get that one. He takes a turret hit for his pleasure. Yellow Peak trying to push back, but he got hit there with the trap. And so I see him taking a lot of damage from Shy. Won't be dying to that one. And now Diamond looking to get in for another kill for the Europeans. Well, that won't happen. Shy, though, forced to flash.
Gotta say, that bottom lane gank was really well timed. The Q right into the Blitzcrank headbutt pulverize just gave them enough time to spike damage before Edward could make the escape. And there's still no support helping Yellow Pete.
Oh, Yellow Pete there flashing at the very last second. Actually, the passive, the headshot was up there for Prey for that final shot as well. So that would have been a kill.
Except you got to remember, Prey actually expended his flash at the very last second of the last fight, so he could not go in to capitalize on that one. I actually don't even think he would have had to burn that flash early. So a very slight opportunity miss in a completely even game.
Well, one thing is going to send Yellow Pete back, although see Prey going back there as well. Wants to spend that money that he's earned from that 55 CS. We can see that Alex in the middle lane started to really push things up as well. And to go back to Prey, when he did go home, second Doran's Blade, Berserker Grease brought in. Let's compare that over to Varus, who right now, as you'd expect with the Varus, going straight into that Cutlass to work up towards the Blade of the Ruined King.
We've seen so much Blade of the Ruined King out of Varus players, especially today. I'm pretty sure every Varus has built it. But the Berserker Greaves rush by Prey, A, it's really good on Caitlyn to get more attack speed and proc more headshots, but it's also a good item against Blitzcrank, because the more move speed you have, obviously the harder it is to hook you in.
Exactly. And right now, he's stood on top of a ward down there, not being as sneaky as you would like to think. There's a pink ward on the top side as well from OGN, so they want to maintain thorough control of those brushes, and that's what you have to do in that Blitzcrank say. You need to know exactly when he's going to pop up and throw that hook your way. The Blue Buffy are just spawning in once again for the OGS champions, and Ambition, of course, is going to be given that.
And we were caught a little bit off guard because there's been so much action bottom lane and so many ganks mid. We haven't touched on, there was a top lane Ryze plus a mid lane Jace in this game. They did do the swap that we thought might happen to champion select, and I'm actually a little bit surprised that Shy has gotten away so much free farming top lane since the action has just been everywhere else.
Yeah, really not much time spent up there. Of course, we did see one visit from Diamond, which resulted in Shy using his flash to escape to safety from that one. Now in this bottom lane, Edward has finally, with Yellow Peak, pushed that lane through so he can get that control of the brush, but that pink ward still remains, and luckily here for the OGN champions, that is a pink ward because Evelyn was just sniffing around.
That's one extra thing teams have to keep in mind when you're playing against an Eve, is the extra gold cost of those pink wards. So this is an 11.8 to 11.8K game. But if OGN champions have to keep using pink wards over and over again, it's going to put them in a little bit of a hole as long as the game stays close like this.
So, some pickups here. Kennen just going on there. Amplifying Zone. Plus, the haunted guy is coming out already. So, going to be bringing a bit of pain to that Jesu. He's actually got the Tio already in there and is close to having that Brutalizer finish as well. Ryze on the top side has got his Catalyst plus that tier as well, and that's because of that, as you said, free farm time that he's had up there.
And that is a great start for Shy. He hasn't even had to buy boots in a long top lane, and he is up by 20 minion kills over Soaz. I cannot say how impressive that is enough. So that could be a huge problem that Europe is going to have to deal with later.
Well, let's find out. We can see there the individual golden. Shy having about 400 of it at this point to give him that lead in there. Middle lane, 100 gold lead for Alex Hitch, obviously picking up that first blood earlier on. As we are going to see the ultimate coming out here from Zoas, and Diamond now going to get involved. He is level 8, so he can get in there with the ulti. And this is a dead Shy. Diamond picks up the kill.
And it's great because that was bound to happen. He pushed up with no boots, and it was a perfect gank timing from Diamond. OGN trying to react with though and make the best out of a bad situation.
Yeah, but there is a ward that they're stood right on top of right now, and that may mean that they push in as Alex here is going head to head with Ambition, but he's losing out on a Diamond on him come in there. He goes down to the Ignite. It was out of Ambition in the end there. Now Lee Sin coming back around. Can Diamond escape from this one? Gets locked onto by Insect, but well, it's hard to lock that down anyway once he hits that W.
Really tough kill there that Ambition picked up on Alex Each. Alex just bit off more than he could chew. He thought he'd win in the brawl since really there was a tier rush on Ambition. He hadn't built any magic resistance, and Alex thought with the haunted guys, he would just be able to outtrade him. But that was clearly not the case. They ended up giving up the kill after the dragon had actually been taken by OGN. So that is a huge moment for OGN in pulling ahead in this game.
Yeah, it puts them almost 1,000 gold into the lead with this one. Just a couple of hundred turns still separating them there from this one. Plastic one now in there for Shy, so he's well on his way to finishing off that Rod of Age, and he's going to have even more time here in this top lane now to have that farming. Got the single Sight Ward, so you know, the thing is, he's not even putting that much into vision for this one.
No, he's actually maybe succumbing to, if Eve comes to gank me, I'm going to die. The few times I saw Flame play Ryze in the top lane, who is her CJ at this blaze, he died two or three times while just farming and then became a monster late game. And it actually seems like Shy's playing the same way. It just so happens that Diamond hasn't tried that much to gank him top lane, and he's just happily fighting, because if Soaz wants to actually fight Shy, he's gonna lose. The only way that they punish him is if they constantly pull up Diamond to gank, and that's gonna open up a whole bunch of other avenues for OGN to take.
So Insect is actually working his way up towards this top lane. I have to say that Soaz not been looking like the Soaz that we know here in this one. I mean, he's got a formidable lane opponent up against him. There's no denying that one. We'll see if he's able to hold this one off. Actually going to get Rune Prisoned up here. Good chunk of damage actually coming down to him. That Lee Sin is still waiting in the brush in the top lane for him.
And they're actually expecting a game from Diamond right now. It's just the fact that Diamond ended up running mid a second ago. Since there was just a successful gank when Shy overpushed without boots, they're expecting Europe to be predictable and do it again, and Diamond and Soaz as well are just not taking the bait.
Well, the fact is that blue one has just come up here as well, and Diamond is going to be picking this one up for himself. This one is going to tank that. Kennen, but obviously for Diamond, a very useful buff to have there as well.
And we could have been wrong about not taking this bait. They may not have predicted the incredibly patient action of Lee Sin, and here it comes.
Here we go. Chai going down for half HP. Look at Insek. He's been stripped to pieces with this one. Is he going to be able to escape? Well, flash for Diamond finishes off. Can they get two here? Flashing flash over. Double kill for Diamond.
Look at that damage that just came out from Rumble and Evelyn. I almost want to say that they knew it was there with the way they just pulled their way in after the quote counter gank came. Like, that Spirit of the Elder Lizard, by the way, is the new hotness on Jungle Eve. Everyone who I've seen doing it has been extremely successful.
Having a very good time of things here. 3-0-1 now as the ball going to come in out towards Mad Life. Is that going to cross them? Headbutt back in towards Turret Rain. He's taking a lot of damage here. Ultimate came out of Yellow Pete. He's trying to force them back with that damage. Acing the hole, blocked by Yellow Pete. But OGN are going to chase him for this one. Grey actually being blocked by minions there a little bit in the end. But there you see the danger of fucking Alistair.
Pulling Mad Life, you just pull yourself into a big old problem. Headbutts him back into that turret. But they actually almost got a kill out of it. I think that was more of a detriment for Europe than it was a benefit. And that is just another example of why that Alistair pick was so strong in lane. If you look at the matchup, Frey is actually up about 13 or so in that bottom lane.
Yeah, nice stuff from him at this point. No kills or assists or death, I say. More Yellow Peter at this stage. But gotta be fair to him, we're not gonna talk about his kills and assists then. No death either for that one. Slowly but surely working his way up to that Blade of the Rune King. Evelyn, after that double kill there for Diamond, has now got that Seeker's Arm Guardian. So really starting to spike in power and Snoke becoming that little less squishy along the way.
And I really like how he's actually taking a large amount of farm against Insek, who is the one known for being the carry jungler over here. And here he comes mid lane!
Oh, that Bishop.
You are gone.
Yeah, I mean, you saw how fast that was. Ultimate out of Kennen, ultimate out of Evelyn. And explosion, just dead. There's nothing really more to say about that one. Fantastic play again by the European LCS All-Stars. I almost said Gambit there, because it was Gambit. It's Alex and Diamond combining again.
And that gank was really set up because they'd already taken the top turret, and Shy was stuck up there farming, so they're gonna have to redistribute themselves now that they got the kill, and Shy is ending up pushing top.
Strong, strong play. Shy pushing that one straight through. Four assists for Soaz. Now, we said he started to fall behind on the farm. He hadn't looked too confident in there, but he's throwing them ultimates out at the right time for Diamond to come in there and finish off those kills. So it's definitely not nothing that he's been doing there up until this point at the top.
Sometimes you just got to get settled in a game like this. This is, I mean, we even heard Yellowpeak talking about them not having a huge amount of practice time. They wish they could have practiced more. They're still getting comfortable with the situation. This is obviously Soaz's first game in this venue, as it is to all the players, but he looks very comfortable now that he's gotten a couple games for Diamond, put really the fear into Shy, knowing he can't just bully him all the way around with Ryze, and also punish the immobility of the top lane Ryze without teleport a little bit by coming bottom for that game.
So, Super Arm Guard is picked up here for Alex in middle. We've just seen him dodging through the acceleration gate. Forget that, because Insek is actually coming here towards Diamond, who is not scared of going in there. Ward put down from Insek to escape, and Diamond will be laughing about that one.
And look at that. He's got two levels on Insek. Diamond is the exact same level as Alex Each, and he just making Insek use those Sightstone wards where he doesn't want them. The Dragon is actually up, and they're deciding to pull a fight off here, and that could be what we're seeing happening, as everyone looks like they're converging towards middle.
Everyone moving in there. We've got Alistair stood on top of a ward there. Frames with him. Mad Life not wanting to get involved. And once that Zonius comes in for Kennen, I think that's going to make Alistair a little bit less effective when it comes to this team fight. If Alex can time it right, we are going to see Mad Life coming in now. This is into a big, big fight. And Soaz takes a lot of damage, but Mad Life being stripped down here. Somehow surviving at the back side there as Alex Inch goes down. They switch around onto Frey. Edward is the focus for OGN. He will be finished off by Shy. Mad Life wanting to get back involved in this one. Diamond now the target. Ambition going to go chasing in. But back in the end, is he going to be able to have enough damage for this one? Gets the slow, knocks it with the hammer, but not quite enough. But there's a kill through the acceleration gate. Gets the shut down. Brilliant play out of OGN.
That was a 3-4-0 for them, and it looked bad when that fight initiated, because Soaz got an equalizer down that really bisected the OGN team, but they flanked around properly. really just the team fight power of Jason Ryze at this point in the game seemed to overtake them. What a one-sided fight that turned out to be, even though it looked close at the start.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that Alex said in the interview earlier on. We're fine when it comes to lane phase, we've seen that in action. But when it comes to team fighting, we are a little bit broken. That's something that, you know, can only come with time when it comes to a team. You saw where the fight was not in central place, it was a little bit unfocused. And that's something that, quite frankly, is going to have to change for the European LCS All-Stars if they want to take down the Koreans.
And it's also a testament to how well the Koreans have came together quickly. They've only had a week to prepare for this event, and there's four different teams being represented here. Playing team fights like that is going to get them far in this tournament.
Another possible lack of communication as two wards go down in that middle lane. Edward just scouting up towards the red to see if he can have a cheeky grab of it and steal it away. There is Shy up the top. Right now, the gap is 20 CS. There or thereabouts still. Has that Rod of Ages finished off? The tier, of course, from Elliot. Got a second lasting one coming in there now as well. What else have we got picked up after that last little fight? Last Whisper being collected by Jace with that Mana Moon and the Brutalizer.
And that Mana Moon is really close to being a Mer Mana. It's at 644 up to 750 mana. When that transforms, that is going to make Ambition a huge issue. Considering he's already got the Brutalizer plus the Last Whisper, all the armor is basically melted off of everyone on Europe. So Jace in these team fights will be totally crazy. That might make up for the fact that, you know, neither of these teams have the Aegis kind of aura type junglers going on. There's a lot of skirmishing happening, and Ambition will be able to solo anyone once he gets that transformation.
So one interesting point to make here as well, that he did fight a couple of shaky performances, one single one I should really say, in that team fight there. They've managed to have a good early game, and with that they've picked up all the outer turrets at this stage.
That is actually super key when you consider that OGN is actually above on gold, despite not having three turrets. So this is a moment where he wants to be able to push an advantage, but every turret closer to the base is more and more difficult to take. And since OGN champions seem stronger in team fights, I don't know how Europe's going to be able to do that. And they're actually conceding a little bit of map positioning just based off of that. Once OGN start taking out these mid turrets, if Europe doesn't contest them, they're actually going to fall a fair bit behind.
I think Edward's going to have to play a part in that one, trying to isolate one man. But there's the problem. We saw it, said it already before. Is that going to be Alice who's going to knock you all up? Is that going to be Lee Sin who's just going to dive back out there towards his team? Probably not. So they've got to be very, very careful about who they bring right into the middle and try and really cut down from this.
And just to expand on that, the way that Insect likes to play Lee Sin often is just diving all the way into a team fight, warding behind someone, jumping to that ward and kicking them back. If you aid him with Edward's pull, it's just going to make that even worse, and then the damage follow-up from Shy and Ambition is just going to win the fight for Korea.
He's coming down, and look at the zoning power here from OGN. They force Rumble into the jungle.
Diamond might
Diamond's
go here.
Up with the top side. It's going to be a great ultimate, but is he going to have the power to carry on through this one? There's the pull. They drag Insect back in there. He should be fine. Mapline, maybe not quite so much as he goes through the acceleration gate. Diamond picks up that kill and goes speeding off to Insect. He drops the ward and will get away from that one. And a big fight ends in just a 1-0 for you.
Diamond pulled off a great flank coming in from behind the team. That is how you play even team fights. You get in behind them, slow them down, and then just poke in and out, never letting them collapse on you. Korea takes a big hit in that team fight. Even though they just lost their support, they used most of their escapes away from that one. There are actually two Sightstone wards used by Insect trying to get away, and Europe is trying to press an advantage here in the small death time of Mad Lions.
Push that one in there. A couple of wards going down. Edward taking that typical Blitzcrank spot. Not aware that he's going to be pulling them from there by now, then I don't know, something wrong at this point. Bottom lane also pushed out, a very real possibility. Jace is there, but the Europeans are collapsing onto that one right now. Wait again behind the wall to see if we can get a sneaky grab onto someone.
And we talked earlier, as long as there's no grab that comes down here that's going to interrupt us, about who is going to be getting the farm on both of these respective teams. Right now, it feels like Ambition is the designated farmer for Korea. He is getting so much, and Insect is giving it to him. Likewise on Europe, even though normally for Gambit, Alex Yeats is actually the guy who takes all the farm, he's not playing like that. Diamond is the one almost playing the Insect role and getting a huge amount of jungle farm on Eve. Could just be because he got a good early start and they're going with it, but it's definitely impactful for this game.
Yeah, and the fact is that we talked about who would maybe get that as Lee Sin is going to go in the Yellow Peak, he gets knocked up. Kennen's going to go into the middle, but Yellow Peak will die. Madline going to fall down as well. Edward going very, very low, gets a pull up in the end, but they're ripping through the rest of them. Double kill coming out for Jai, and they're not done just yet. They're going to chase down Diamond. That is the 90 caliber net through the wall. The Piltover Peacemaker not quite landing, and Diamond going to speed away. And the Ace in the hole, not quite enough damage, but that is four kills for one, and that one was the support.
That was amazing team fighting. Madlife being selfless at the end, but really, the ward in kickback by Insec on Lee Sin is so potent, and you could see that Urim just was not ready for it. They comboed it up so well, and now they don't even have to worry about Lee Sin not having an Aegis. They're going to get the initiations as well as they want.
Turret taken down, so that turret advantage we were talking about slowly grinded away, and that's an inner turret in the middle lane, probably the biggest one. And we're going to have another look back, though, at that last fight, a big one for the OGN champions.
And the start of this fight was just so key. When Insec comes in behind Yellowbeat, Q's in, wards back, kicks in. That is so hard to execute. Even though Europe tried to calm Wooden, made really everyone sit on the Rumble ultimate, they'd already lost their AD carry, and they burned all their CC release and counter initiation. So the rest of Korea just chased down Europe.
And Chai even survived at the end of that one, even being on such low HP. Real credit to the start there from Insec, but really the execution overall from the Koreans looking very strong. They're now 970 kills up, 3,300 gold is currently the lead that they have, and the Dragon is now available.
And I'd expect, actually, OGN to want to just group up and take this one. Europe looks to be the ones forcing it, but they have been losing team fight after team fight, so this may be a bit of a desperation force. They were hoping to be able to sneak that one down, but I think they saw the ward and killed it off.
Yeah, taking that one down, and we must have a sniff that something is going to come their way here. OGN Champions All-Stars. Let's see. There's the Oracle on Madlife, which will help clear one out. They're going to look to steal the blue buff as Jace. Going to put down a lot of damage already onto Edward. That blue buff is going to be taken here by Diamond.
And this may not be a great start. They're going in for the fight.
But Madlife's at the front. He's going to get the knock-up onto every one of them. And there is a headbutt. Alex taken away. His ultimate not going to have much effect on this team fight. And that's surely death here for the Europeans. There is Edward going down. We've already seen Alex die. Diamond now going to be the next target. Madlife gets closer. The acceleration gate gonna help things out, but the slow out of Varus will stop them in their tracks.
Another 2-0 for the Korean team here, and after the Blitzcrank hook missed, even though Yellow Pete landed the ultimate, it may not have been the best time to go in because they didn't have a priority target taken out at the start of that fight, and really, it allowed Insec to go pull off his magic again. That kick, it was actually the least an ultimate to kick Alex Hitch out of that fight. And Insec MVP so far, even though he's not taking the carry role, it's more Diamond taking the majority of farm out of the jungle. I think last I checked, Diamond had the most gold on Europe, whereas Ambition is just out of this world as far as gold has, getting all the farm while Insec still hasn't missed a beat.
Really, really impressive stuff coming out of the OGN Champions. Look down the items, they're actually copies of each other on some fronts for the Europeans. Three Haunted Geyser straight in there. A couple of those secret arm cards in as well. So now that's not the easiest thing in the world to work with because, well, quite frankly, open for OGN, they're saying, well, Magic Resist, that's going to be the name of the game here. The Hex Drinker already brought in there. There's a Negatron cloak for Ryze. And you can see that's just going to keep fading as things go on.
And most importantly, it's the Runic Bulwark on Insec as well. It's just not enough AoE damage up front for Europe right now to be able to win these fights. Korea's doing a really good job also of not grouping up to get hit by all of it. It looks like those Rumble ults are hitting a lot of people, but generally they're just hitting Madlife and maybe one other person. And since Madlife gets off his Alistar combo, he's pretty much done his job in the fight during the one rotation. The rest of the fight is decided after that.
Madlife walking over a warden. Not sure if he actually spotted that one, but either way, it's going to give Edward the chance to get back down there and get a bit of vision back for the Europeans here. With another one and takes a shock blast through the acceleration gate, which, third of his health, not at all bad in terms of damage.
Yeah, Ambition getting really, really big. 266 to 178 if you compare just the mid lane farm. But that's also because Ambition's been getting so much of the side lane farm in this game as well. Those shock blasts are absolutely killing, especially Edward, since Edward has put all of his resources really into Oracle so he can try to get himself into sneaky positions to land these Blitzcrank hooks, which actually just hasn't paid off.
Europe just trying to push them out here, trying to gather as much farm as they can. I mean, if we look at the levels earlier on, Diamond, I mean, he's level 15 right now. Earlier on, he had a lead over most people, even over Ambition at that stage, who is now level 17. Insek is still a little bit behind, but we've seen the power of him. It just needs that one kick to set everything up.
And the game is really just paused for Europe, but not for Korea, because Korea's continued to farm and get kills, whereas Europe has just been losing teamfight after teamfight, and they're getting starved out. It was 3-0 a little while ago, but now it's 3-4. And that goal lead is really just ballooned in large part because of the global gold from those turrets.
7,000 gold lead coming in currently for the OGN champions. Definitely one of the big favorites here to take now at All-Star Weekend. But there's still a long way to go. Of course, if you lose the first best team, you're not out. They will go down to play the North American LCS All-Stars, whichever team that would be. And then the winner of this game will play the winner of that loser's game as well earlier, later on. Which, of course, you can find the brackets over on lolesports.com, so don't get confused with that. But look at this.
For as much effort as Europe has put in with Edwards Oracles, it gives them no Baron control whatsoever. They were too scared of OGN. They've jumped in, at least Insect over the wall, and that's a Baron taken based off of map control and sap.
And the funny thing is there is a ward just south there of that Baron pit, which just didn't give them anything to work with when you come in from that top side. Very, very difficult.
I wasn't paying enough attention. I feel like Shy came down from the top lane,
Sin
jumped over the wall, and Prey was shooting it from behind the back of the pit, or he jumped in, so they thought they had the approach ward done, but they really just got snuck up on, and the Baron was pretty much taken out from under what they thought they had vision of.
That balloons the gold here. A huge chunk for the Koreans. It's going to give them items as well, which are going to be helping as we go. We've got the the Muramana in their last whisper, Black Cleaver right now for Jace with the Hex Drinker as well. I mean, that is a very scary Jace.
Oh dear, this is not going to be happy fights for Europe if they get in for them. Maybe their salvation here is there's no one with a huge amount of armor on the OGN champions team yet, so if they decide to turret dive, the turret aggro is actually going to matter a fair bit. But it is not looking that good just with how quickly they've been losing these fights in the past, especially if they get picked off somewhere before a turret dive could happen.
Oh, and look at that. Diamond just walked through a ward before his stealth had kicked in here. And there is an Oracle on that Alistair, so he needs to be very careful. Jace is coming down as well. Mindful will put another ward in. Insect gonna spot him now. Will again kick him back into play. Diamond gonna pop his W. Can he escape this one though? Insect gonna be slowed there. And people decide to back away, but they were close to locking off Diamond.
They really wanted to get that, so they had the fear of a Diamond Evelyn flank gone when they try to get in for these turrets. That's why Insect burned so much to try to get that one. Because he survived, he may be able to make it back with this one, but they really have to be able to survive the poke before they can even think about holding this turret.
30 minutes in, 310 CS right now for Ambition. And you can see how much he's hurting with all those items that CS and the kills have allowed for him right now. 12,500 to just 8,500 over with Alexis. That is a humongous lead, and OGN aren't going to be taking turret number 5.
And they may just try to continue this one into the base. They still have about half of their Baron left on their timer, so they can keep this push going for about another minute and a half. And they're actually just taking hits from this turret, even though they don't have a guy with a whole bunch of armor.
They're not really too scared of things by the looks of it. And with that Jace poke added into that as well, you can never underestimate with Jace. He's such a versatile champion. I mean, it helps when you've got 300 CS as well.
Yeah, you're pretty versatile when you have 50% more gold than everyone else on the team. You can kind of do anything. His poke is obviously the biggest strength, but because of the Muramana and the blue buff specifically, when he gets actually engaged on, the distance gets closed after the poke, he's still incredibly dangerous, which is one of the reasons that Europe is just so trapped in their base right now.
Wow, and again, Ambition just waiting things up. The hook from Edward didn't really land on his target, and there is the turret going down. Oh. And they are going to go in for this one. Flash has burned by the Koreans, not getting anything for that, but they will be taking that inhibitor after the hard work was done for the turret. In the meantime, Insect, in perfect timing, has pushed the middle lane out, and they may be able to have this as well.
Europe's not going to let it happen. They're going.
Ultimate's coming down left and right, but it's not much damage coming out. Shine will finally be focused. He gets shut down. Edward will go into the middle. He's running very low and will die to Ambition. There's the ace in the hole. Soaz blocks it, and a double buff there was given over, actually, onto Jace.
And OGN is just going to continue to push this one. Everyone got so low on Europe, this could be inhibitor number 2.
And it will be inhibitor number 2. members who nothing whatsoever. P and LCS All-Stars can do to stop that one. And it comes back out of the base, but it just shows you the difference in items and power that they're at this stage of the game.
I still really like the effort from Europe to try to initiate on that turret, because you could tell OGN was getting a little bit greedy, trying to get both inhibitors during the Baron buff push. And if Europe didn't try to punish them there, they would have basically just given up the game. But because they ended up one for one in that fight and still losing the inhibitor, I'd say their percentage went even more drastically down to win this game.
Dragon has been picked up for what it's worth here after 35 minutes, which is going to be more gold for Caitlyn, who picks up the Silver Sash, and for Lee Sin, who's going to pick up the Smurf Code Home Guard style, and also the Hex Drinker coming out for him as well.
Yeah, they're really loving the Hex Drinker type of builds. Obviously, Ambition has finished his Maw of Malmortius as well. We knew they were going to be going for Magic Resist earlier, and they've really just done it across the board. Spirit Visage on Shy, that's not a normal Ryze item, but when you think about the way Ryze works, he really needs cooldown reduction to cycle, and normally you think it's a Glacial route. A lot of people get panicked into building that in the Frozen Heart. But because they're against a double AP composition, he's went for a Spirit Visage, and it's genius. I've barely seen Ryze do this, but it works so amazingly well.
Yeah, big chunk of Magic Resist that comes off that one. Helping out a ton. We've got two Abyssal Scepters come out, actually, on the other side of the Europeans, trying to say, well, we need to get rid of some of that Magic Resist as it comes.
And those builds won't really be completed until they could get a Void Staff, but they're so trapped along items, they didn't get enough gold rarity to pull this off, and the mid-game power that OGN actually pushed on them has stopped them from getting to their final form.
That's another, and the final, we should say, in a turret taken down for Koreans. Moving on towards that inhibitor turret as well. Yellow P, third of his health gone without one single shot blast.
And we have to remember, this was 3-0 for Europe. The last 8 turrets have been taken by OGN with no answer. And the poke may continue here, but the things that OGN has on their mind is they know there's 2 inhibitors down, which means Europe has to have a full-time base defender. If they just wait another minute, they could go for this third inhibitor with a Baron buff as well. So I see a lot of patience out of OGN here. Maybe not. Insect jumps into the base, but I wouldn't expect an incredibly aggressive move from Korea here unless they're feeling real confident.
Insect got wards, and unless they stun him instantly, he's gonna get away from it. There's no way that Insect should be making that kind of mistake and trying to just bait the Europeans into something there and get him down to half HP. 30 seconds here until this Baron comes up, but it looks like the Greens want to get in there for the fight before they even go for that one. Diamond is low. Insect is gonna knock Alex Itch out there as well. He will finally zone yours up. But will that be enough here for Europe? Alex finally goes down. They've lost Blitzcrank. They're gonna lose Varus as well. And this is a whitewash fight. 2 men left alive, but he's been chased down by Varus. And the, by Jason Caitlyn, finished off by Praise Ace in the hole. And, well, Shy is even tanking up the fountain at this point. This is going to be game, and it is going to be the Koreans that take game number one.
And at the end of that, they were feeling pretty confident because they did not waste any time finishing that one off. They could have waited the minute for the Baron, but they knew they were so far ahead. Again, Insect used the ward initiation, jumped in and kicked. That was a brilliant performance by them.
Yeah, and he was really close at the start. I mean, we say close, but Europe really had a great start of things in the early game. I mean,
really
we talked about how the whole synergy has got to work for you. It's having 3 members from Gambit in there, and that's what they played to. They said, that's going to be our strength here. Let's try and play to it. We saw Diamond Vincent in that middle lane often, really doing well. But look at how Ambition ended. He gave away first blood in that game, but he was the one that really did the work. Masses of CS, masses of kills, masses of items, and that was the first game.
And we wanted to know how Korea would come in with the team effort, and they really showed it that way. There were people sacrificing for the betterment of the team right there.
Yeah.
Insect's Lee Sin was not necessarily farm heavy, but he did enough work, was the first man in, had just enough to make it happen, and completely controlled that game. Sure, Ambition had all the minion kills, but when you're farming that much, sometimes you're not necessarily the one starting the fights. You're the one cleaning up and getting strong. Insect was all over the place.
Yeah, and I don't think we're going to be seeing a Lee Sin. Just a hunch that I've got coming into game number 2. We'll find out, of course, a little bit later. But for now, we're going to head over to Rivington and Freak to take us through the highlights from game number 1.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. And I think the beginning of this matchup really told us that Diamond was EU's best friend. And then it started to go a little wry. We started to see the fights, and we started to see the Insect. Like Jat said, he wasn't farm heavy. He didn't have it all in the bag, but he had enough to make it work every time they fought.
What I really liked was the Sightstone Lee Sin. The second I saw that item get released, I was like, that's going to be so fun on Katarina and Lee Sin. I'll jump towards all day. And you saw how powerful the extra mobility was. Normally it's flash kicks. It was ward kicks. That was
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Yeah. So let's take a look at these replays.
Yeah, so the very first clip that we're going to show from this game is basically a 4-for-1 at the turret down here. As we started out, it's going to be almost your everyday fight, except that Insect gets an amazing initiation on Yellow Pete. Let's roll it. Watch Insect. He's amazing. Jumps actually to a ward, kicks Yellow Pete forward, and then everyone follows up. He calls go, and they get him for free. And then it's a very close fight for EU. They almost get the damage, but watch this. Insect shields Shy so that he doesn't fall to Diamond's Q spam, and they're able to just clean up the fight from there. Insect was super on point that entire game. Played absolutely beautifully.
You know, Freak, we heard Alex Yeats say they're very strong in lanes. They like the way they're cooperating, the way that SOAZ can play aggressive in the top lane, but it was the fighting phase where they found a falter.
Exactly. The team fights were just way, way better for the Korean team. There was one at Dragon where Madlife comes in, pops the Alistar ultimate, right. The Kennen ult comes by, and he just doesn't hit enough people. And the next time you see a Dragon fight, Kennen ult comes by, and he gets Lee Sin kicked out and doesn't do anything with the Slicing Maelstrom. And we kind of saw that time and again, that the everyone press R and kill everything at once never actually worked for EU.
Absolutely. All right, thank you for the replay. And we've got to take a short break, but when we return, the Korean OG and champions try to lock down this best of three series and a trip to the semifinals. The 2013 League of Legends All-Star Weekend will be right back. Stick around.